Hey, if you've got a physically or mentally demanding job, or maybe a crazy lifestyle that precludes you from getting enough rest, you have to take a different approach from fitness. You see, you cannot always be go, 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 go. If you're a type A individual who likes to get after it and have a fun weekend and then try to get right back in the gym, this is a very short-sighted approach. Instead, no matter how stressed you are, no matter how hectic your lifestyle, this is what you need to do in order to make the best progress possible in the gym. Hey, so let me tell you a popular example. I work with a ton of busy executives, and the most common thing that they like to do when they get started is go full throttle into high intensity training 4, 5, 6, sometimes 7 days per week, and then follow a low carb, low calorie diet. You know why? Because it works extremely well for 30 days, 4 weeks, 5 weeks, 6 weeks. But unfortunately, here's what happens. Damn near every single time, people fall off because it's not practical. Because they're stressed. They might lose 7, 8, 9, 12 pounds in that first couple weeks. Then all of a sudden, the weight gain comes back. Or stress gets so high that they fall off. And overall, they never build that long-term sustainable approach. So if you're somebody who's extremely stressed, has a hectic lifestyle, and find it very difficult to make progress long-term, these are a couple important tips that you need to take and implement immediately if you want to make a long-term transformation. Number one, start small. This is going to be a killer if you like to get after it, but here's the key. You see, a lot of people will try to go after the most aggressive plan, and they never make the goal stick long term. So if your plan would ideally be to train 60 minutes, 5 days per week, why don't you start with 20 and lock in that habit of getting into the gym that 5 days per week first? Again, if something is too big, it's going to be difficult to accomplish. As popular brain coach Jim Quick says, inch by inch, it's a cinch. Yard by yard, way too hard. Maybe that was Dr. Seuss. All right. Hey, number two, active stress management, meaning you need to have some proactive stress management strategies, whether it's meditation or what I like to recommend, going for a walk, just focusing on the one question, what can I do today to make it a success? If you do that, go for the walk and meditate on that one question and focus on your breathing throughout the day, that will dramatically reduce your stress and give you clarity with what you need to be doing. Now with your training, here's one thing you should do specifically. You see, a lot of people want to jump into those long workouts as I talked before, but you should actually focus on going a little bit shorter. This is going to be more effective use of your time and reduce training volume. So training volume is the amount of sets/reps that you're doing on a regular basis. But it's been shown that excess volume, particularly if your form's not up to point and you're not getting enough sleep, can dramatically increase central nervous system stress and overall fatigue. So get in, get out, and have a lower volume training approach. Then when it comes to nutrition, I do not recommend going ultra low carb. Now, carnivore, keto, all these low carb diets can be all the rage right now. And the reason they're so popular is because potentially reduced inflammation. You hear different things about cognitive performance. But the biggest thing to understand here is a low carbohydrate diet does very well for fat loss because you're reducing calories. And with lower carbohydrates, your body's going to store less water weight, which might feel like less inflammation as well. But also when it comes to the cognitive benefits of a low carb diet, need to understand that a lot of times those cognitive benefits or that clarity that you feel is actually the increase of cortisol, the increase of stress hormones. So if you have a stressed lifestyle and now you're following a diet that's going to increase stress even more, it might work well short term, but overall, if you're not eating any carbohydrates, you're really going to struggle long term. So we recommend actually a carbohydrate backloading approach. So you can actually restore your body, not deal with a ton of insulin spikes throughout the day, but have enough carbohydrates to be able to relax and chill later in the day to reduce that stress. But overall, as a busy professional, if you have a lot of things going on, a lot of stressors in terms of work, life, and training, you need to understand that all stress attacks that same component of the body. It all goes into the same bucket. So what you need to do is not bite off the most aggressive plan possible, but instead focus on what you can do consistently while actively reducing stress in your life. Now, if you want help in terms of reducing stress, comment stress in the comments below, and I'll tell you one simple step that we can help implement daily to help you reduce stress so you can look, feel, and perform your best. All right, have a great day.